Well, it looks like the Israeli-Palestinian conflict may have a new negotiator. China's foreign minister, speaking with Al-Arabiya TV channel, saying the Chinese government plans to invite Israelis and Palestinians to hold talks inside the country. China has offered itself several times in the past as an alternative to the United States when it comes to mediating between Israelis and Palestinians, coming up with proposals to end their decades-old conflict. Could this be the right time? Let's ask Matan Vilnai, Israel's former ambassador to China, among many other titles. Thank you so much for joining us, sir. So the Chinese government hasn't given too much information now, but is it surprising that they're trying to offer themselves as negotiators?
When I was ambassador several years ago, they have the same initiative. They have a plan of 4 points. I'm not sure that I remember the points, but I am sure that the Chinese can be a mediator between us and the Arab world, especially with the Palestinians, in the situation of today. I'm sure about it.
So, Matan, why is China the best place for these negotiations to take place?
They are a superpower, and they have no history in the Middle East that someone is angry about them and this and that. They came, they are coming now in a new position, a new superpower that can do a lot between us and our world because they have known something from the past.
And how possible is it that the Israelis and Palestinians will actually end up taking them up on this offer?
First of all, they have to speak with all the groups in the region and to understand every position. It will take time, it's not easy, because it's very complicated. And because, as I said before, they have no experience here, they have to start from the beginning and to start to study as much as they can about every nation, every people, the positions, the attitude, the situation, everything. And then they will decide how to do it. And as I know the Chinese, they are very smart. They will understand what are the problems, and they can be some kind of a host to deal with a very problematic situation in this area, in this field.
Sir, the United States has famously always been the main point of negotiation for this conflict. What is this saying about the U.S. role in the Israeli-Palestinian conflict?
The Chinese will be very careful about the U.S. role in the region because, as I remember it, when I was ambassador, and I was ambassador till 2017, January 2017, so it's more than 4 years now, they understood that the Middle East is under the American influence. And they were very careful not to interfere in the Middle East because it's U.S. domination. If they are going to change it, this position, first of all, they have to coordinate with the U.S. in some way or another. They can't go to the Middle East without talking with America in the first place, and then to decide how to do it.
So if China does step in, could this be a new dynamic that could actually perhaps lead to some progress in some talks that have really been under stalemate for a very long time?
After they will study the positions and the attitude among the groups, the nations, the countries in the Middle East, they have to decide how to continue. And I'm sure that they can have new ideas, new attitude, and there will be a new force in the area. And I believe that it could be very good for us, for the Israel and the Arab side as well. And I would like to emphasize the most important thing as we in Commander for the Security of Israel believe that the most pressing issue now in the Middle East, as it was in the last decade, more than a decade, it's the relation between the Palestinians and the Israelis. Although our government trying to push it aside, it's the main issue, not because they endanger us. We are much stronger than them. This is not the issue. But at the end, if there will be no solution to the Palestinian problem, we'll find ourselves with one state between the Med Coast and the Jordan Valley, which means the eastern border of Israel, with one country for two people, Israelis and Palestinians. And this is very dangerous for Israel. And therefore, we must find a solution to this.
All right, Matan Vilnai, thank you very much for joining me today.